हेलो एवरीवन, गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स. डियर स्टूडेंट्स, इन प्रीवियस क्लास वी टेक एंड डिस्कस अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट चैप्टर ऑफ योर सिलेबस विच इज़ व्हाट, कोऑर्डिनेट ज्योमेट्री. एंड इन दैट क्लास वी डिस्कस ऑल द इंपॉर्टेंट टॉपिक, ऑल द इंपॉर्टेंट क्वेश्चंस रिलेटेड टू कोऑर्डिनेट ज्योमेट्री वी डिस्कस एंड कंप्लीटेड. नाउ इन दैट क्लास वी आर गोइंग टू टेक एंड स्टार्ट अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट चैप्टर ऑफ योर सिलेबस विच इज़ व्हाट, लाइन्स एंड एंगल्स. Lines and angle. This is one of the most important chapter of your syllabus. Before that, first of all, we are going to discuss about the what is the concept of lines and angles. You know that, dear students, if we have two points A and B, and if we just joining them, then it is said to be a line segment. Okay, and in this way, a line segment denoted by in this way AB bar. Okay, this is what a line segment. In this way, we can say that any line segment contains two have two ends points. Okay, now if that line segment extend in only one direction, then it is said to be a ray, and ray is denoted by in this way. Means in this way we can say that a ray have only one end points. Okay, now if any line segment AB extends in both the direction, then it is said to be a line. This is the concept of line, dear students. If any line segment extends in both the direction, then it is said to be a line. This is the concept of line. Okay, in this way we can say that, and it is denoted by in this way. This is the representation of line. Okay, and in this way we can say that a line have no end points. So this is the concept of line segment, ray and lines. So please clear the concept of that. Now we are going to discuss about angles. Let's see, dear students, we are going to discuss about an angle. Let's see. Suppose that, dear student, we draw a ray OA. Suppose that dear student, we draw a ray OA. If that ray rotate in anti-clockwise direction, suppose that rotate anti-clockwise direction, and its final position is what? OB. It rotate in anti-clockwise direction, and then its final position becomes that OB. Now that angular displacement of that ray is known as an angle. So this is an angle what? AOB, or you can say that BOA. Okay, so this is the concept of that. And here O is called the vertex of an angle. This is what? This is the vertex of an angle. OA and OB are two rays. Okay, so this is the concept of what? Lines and angles. Now we are going to discuss about some important topic in that chapter. That's why in that chapter, firstly we are discuss about the topic complement and supplement angle, complementary and supplementary angles. We are going to discuss about complementary and supplementary angles. Okay, what is the concept of that? Dear sir, in previous classes you already discussed about you already known about that, ki what is the concept of supplementary and complementary angles. You already know about that. Okay, what is the concept of that? Now in that class we discuss one more time that topic, like complementary and supplementary angles. Let's see, dear student, if the sum of two angles is what? If suppose two angles are there, angle A and angle B are there, if their sum of measure is 90, if angle A plus angle B is equal to what? 90, then it is said to be complementary to each other. This is the condition for complementary angle. Two angles are said to be complementary to each other if their sum of measures is what? 90. In case if we take one angle BX, then its complement will be 90 minus X. Similarly, for supplement is what? For supplementary angle, suppose angle A and angle B, two angles are there. If their sum of measures is what? 180 degree. If their sum of measures is what? 180 degree, then it is said to be what? Supplementary angles. Okay, if we take one angle Vx, then its supplement will be 180 minus x. So in this way, this is the concept of what? Complementary and supplementary angles. The two angles are said to be supplementary to each other if their sum of measures is what? 180. If two angles are said to be complementary to each other if their sum of measures is what? 90 degrees. So this is the concept of that. Now we are going to discuss about the adjacent angles, linear pairs, vertical and vertically opposite angles. Let's see, dear students. Now we are going to discuss about what? The topic adjacent angle. Now we are going to discuss about adjacent angles. What is the concept of adjacent angles, dear friends? Know about that? Let's see. Dear friends, two angles are said to be adjacent if and only if they contains three properties. First one, let's see. Suppose that we draw this one. Let's see. Two AB and OA and OB are two rays, and our third ray draw in this way. Let's see here. These are called adjacent angles because adjacent angles, two angles are said to be adjacent if and only if first they have the what? Same vertex. They have the same vertex. Second one, they have the common arms. And third one is what? Their non-common arms are either side of the common arm. So this is the conditions for what? This is three important criteria for adjacent angles. Okay, let's see. Here different here angle AOC and angle BOC. Angle BOC are what? Adjacent angles. Why it is called adjacent angles, dear students? Because of they have the same vertex. So, okay, they have the same vertex. So they have the common arm OC, and their non-common arms are either side of the common arm. So this is the conditions for adjacent angles. Okay, so this is very important. Please clear the concept of that. Now we are going to discuss about the linear pair. Let's see. Now we are clear about the topic. Linear pair. What is the concept of linear pair? Here, sir, two adjacent angles are said to be linear pair if and only if they also have the three condition. Let's see. Suppose that we draw two ray OA and OB, and third ray stand on it, OC. So here angle AOC, this is angle AOC, and this is angle BOC. They are found what? Linear pair. Why? Because of, let's see. Yes, and for linear pair, first condition is they have the common vertex. Second one, so common vertex. So, okay, they have the common arm. They have the common arm. And last one, their non-common arms are opposite rays. Okay, this is the condition for what? This is the condition for linear pairs. Okay, they are non-common arm as opposite rays, and so in this way we can say that their sum of measures is what? 180 degree, because this is the straight line, na? So thus for linear pair, angle AOC plus angle BOC is always equal to 180 degree. This is the condition for linear pair. Okay, dear friends. So in this way, you clear the concept of that. Now we are going to discuss about the vertically opposite angles. Let's see. Now we are discuss about the vertically opposite angles. Okay, what is the concept of that, dear friends? Let's see. If two lines are intersect each other, suppose that A, B and C, D are two lines, they are intersect each other at O. They are intersect each other at point O. Then the vertically opposite angles are formed is what? Angle AOC, pair of vertical angle AOC and angle BOD. This is first pair, and second one, angle BOC and angle AOD. So these are the two pairs of vertically opposite angles when two lines are intersect each other. Okay, and one of the most important concept of that is what? Ki the vertically opposite angles, the vertically opposite angles are equal to each other. Theek? This is the concept of that. This is one of the most important concept related to that topic, and one of the most important result between them, the vertically opposite angles are equal to each other, means angle AOC is equal to angle BOD and angle BOC is equal to angle AOD. This is the conditions for what? Vertically opposite angles. Okay, so please, dear sir, first of all, you clear the concept of each and every topic which we discuss in that class, like complementary and supplementary angles, adjacent angles, linear pairs and vertically opposite angles. All are very important concept related to that chapter. Okay, now let's see. Now, so in this way, now we are clear the concept of transversal. What is the concept of transversal? Let's see. Dear friends, suppose that if two lines are there, here, suppose if two lines are there, L and M, okay? And a third line cuts these two lines in two distinct points like A and B. Then that line is said to be what? Transversal. This is the concept of transversal. Okay, dear students, if two lines intersect each other, two parallel lines are there and one line intersect these lines and two distinct point A and B, then that line T, suppose that line T is called the transversal. And some angles made by the transversal are, let's see, this is, we take 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So here there are corresponding angles are found, vertically opposite alternate interior angles are found, vertically opposite angles are formed, and co-interior angles are formed by that transversal. Okay, this one, this is one of the most important concept related to that topic. Here angle 1, 5, 2, 4, 2, 6, 4, 8, 3, 7 are the pair of corresponding angles. 3, 5. Angle 3, angle 5 are, and 4, 6, pair of alternate interior angles. Angle 4, angle 5 and angle 3, angle 6 are the pairs of co-interior angles. Okay, and vertically opposite angles are equal, sorry, alternate interior angle means angle 3 is equal to angle 5 and angle 4 is equal to angle 6. Okay, and our corresponding angles are also equal. एंड को इंटीरियर एंगल आर सप्लीमेंट्री, मीन्स एंगल 4 प्लस एंगल 5 इज इक्वल टू 180, एंगल 3 प्लस एंगल 6 आल्सो इक्वल टू 180. नाउ वी टेक सम क्वेश्चन बेस्ड ऑन दिस टॉपिक. लेट्स सी. Now we take some question. Your question is what? An angle is equal to, an angle is equal to 8 times its complement. Its complement. Okay, find the angle. This is very important question based on the topic complementary angle. Let's see its solution. Here an angle is equal to 8 times of its complement. Find that angle. So first of all, let us consider the angle be x. Okay, let us consider the angle be x, then its complement will be, what, 90 minus x. Okay, then its complement will be what, 90 minus x. Now according to question, an angle is equal to 8 times of its complement, means that angle x is equal to 8 times of its complement, means what, 90 minus x. That angle x is 8 times its what, complement. Now we simplify them. Let's see. So we get what, x is equal to, we multiply them, this is 72 minus this is 8x. Now we transfer that side, x plus 8x is equal to 720, so that is 9x is equal to 720. So x is equal to 7980. Thus the required angle x is what, 80 degrees. This is the required solution of the given question. Okay, this one. So in this way you can solve that type of question based on complement angle. Now we take and solve some other important question of your syllabus based on lines and angles. Let's see, dear students. Now find angle AOC and angle BOC. Find angle AOC and angle BOC and angle BOC in the given figure. And your figure is, let's see. OA, OB, and third ray OC stand on it. Okay, here what I find here, we find that angle AOC and angle BOC in the given figure, and here angle AOC is 4x and this is 2x. Okay, now let's see its solution. Dear students, this is a very important question based on the topic linear pairs. Let's see. Here from in the given figure, angle AOC and angle BOC form a linear pair. A linear pair. And in previous class, and in previous, just I discussed about that topic, because of why it is linear pair, because of both the angles have the common vertex O, common arm OC, and their non-common arms are opposite rays. So they form a what? They form a linear pair. Now, what is the condition for linear pair? Their sum of measures is what? 180. That is, we know that. That is, we know that angle AOC plus angle BOC is equal to what? 180. Now we put the value of angle AOC and angle BOC in the given formula. So we get AOC is what? This is 2x here we put. BOC is what? This is 4x is put. 180. Now we get this is 6x is equal to 180. That is x is equal to 180 upon 6, 3 is 80, 0. Thus the value of x is what? 30. Now what we find? Dear friend, we find angle AOC and angle BOC. Thus, let's see. Thus, angle AOC is what? Angle AOC what? 2x, na? That is 2 into 30. This is 60 degree. This is first answer. And angle BOC. And angle BOC what? 4x. That is 4 into x is what? And this is 30. So we get what? 120 degree. Okay. So this is the concept of that questions. In this way, you can solve, dear friends, each and every question of your NCERT exercise based on the topic linear pairs. Now we take and discuss some other important question based on these topics. Let's see, dear students. In the given figure, find the value of C. Let's see, your question is, in the given figure, find the value of C, and your figure is here. XY is a straight line. Here XY is a straight line. OP is a strand on, this is perpendicular. OP, and here this is your O, this is MN, is also line passes through the point O, okay? And this is A, this is B, and this is C. And let's see, the ratio of A and B given is that, given the A or and the ratio of A angle AB is what? 2:3. Okay, it is given that in your question. So this is one of the most important question. Let's see its solution. Dear friend, first of all, let's see its solution. Here in the given figure, we find the value of angle C. Here angle XOM is given as B, angle POM is given as angle A, okay, and angle POY is 90 degree according to question. Now, and the ratio of angle AB is what? 2:3. Let the angles A and B are 2x and 3x respectively. Okay, now from figure we have, now from figure we have, let's see, now let's see from figure what I have. Let's see, dear friends, here in that figure XOY is a straight line and sum of all angles on the straight line is always what? 180 degree, na? Always what? 180 degree. So let's see. Now we have एक्स ओ वाई इज अ स्ट्रेट लाइन इज अ स्ट्रेट लाइन दैट इज एंगल एक्स ओ एम प्लस एंगल एम ओ पी प्लस 90 इज इक्वल टू 180 डिग्री. नाउ एक्स ओ एम इज वाट, दिस इज बी इज वाट 3x, दिस इज 2x प्लस 90 इज इक्वल टू 180. नाउ दिस इज 5x इज इक्वल टू 180 माइनस 90 दैट इज वाट 90 डिग्री. ओके, नाउ फ्रॉम देयर द वैल्यू ऑफ x इज इक्वल टू 90 अपॉन 5 विच इज वाट 18. दस एंगल x इज इक्वल टू वाट 18. नाउ that is angle A is what, this is 2x that is 2 into 18 this is 36 degree and value of angle B is equal to what 3x which is what 3 into 8 that is 54 degree. Okay, now again from figure we find the value of C. Na, now we take MN is a straight line through O. Now again from figure, now again from figure, MON is a straight line, MON is a straight line now, then the sum of angle B and C is what 180, that is angle B plus C is equal to 180 degree. Now we put the value of angle B is what 54 plus C is equal to 180. Now the value of C is 180 minus 54. Okay, so what I get, now we subtracting them, so we get what 126 degree. This is the required solution of the given question. So this is the, in this way you can solve that type of question, okay, which is very important for you and your upcoming examination. So please dear student, do more and more practices of that type of question. After that you can solve each and every questions of your NCERT exercise. Okay, now dear friends, we take and solve some other important question. Okay, and your question is, if an angle 2x minus 10 degree and x minus 5 degree are complementary. Your question is, if two angles, suppose that angle A is equal to 2x minus 10 degree and angle B is equal to x minus 5 degree are complementary, and then find the value of x. Here your question is, angle A and B are what? Complementary. Find the value of x. Now let's see its solution. Dear student, you know that two angles are said to be complementary to each other if their sum of measure is what 90 degree. Okay, now let's see, since angle A and angle B are what complementary to each other, that is their sum of measures is what 90 degree. Their sum of measure is what 90 degree. Now that is, this is 2x minus 10 plus x minus 5 is equal to 90. So we get, this is 3x, this is minus 15 is equal to 90. That is 3x is equal to 90 plus 15. That is 105. So x is equal to 105 upon 3. 3 is a 9, 3 5 is a 15. Thus the value of
x is what? 35.
Now, in this way, you can solve that type of question. Okay, in this way, in today class, we take and discuss some other some important topic related to your chapter complementary angles. Now, in next class, we take and discuss some other important topic of your syllabus of that chapter, means lines and angles, and solving some important question of your exercise. Okay, now thanks to all.